What's up guys, Virgil here for JRPG Central, and today I'm going to be giving you 7 beginner tips for Disgaea 1 Complete. These tips should also apply to all versions of the game, so whether you're playing on the DS, the PSP, PS2, PS4, PC, or the Nintendo Switch, these will hopefully help ease you into the game if you are completely new to the series. So without any further ado, on to the video. Tip number 1 is to utilize specialists in the item world. Something you want to start making a habit of early on is taking note of the specialists on your weapons and equipment. Specialists are listed under the item status panel and are actually creatures that live inside that item. These little guys give a boost to specific stats and can be really useful. By going into the item world with these items, you can subdue the specialists, which I believe increases the stat bonus they give, but more importantly makes it to where you can move them around to different items. This allows you to fully customize your gear with the best stat bonuses you want. Personally, I highly recommend getting Statistician and Arms Master on anything and everything you can, as they will boost the XP you get, as well as how fast you learn your weapon skills. Nice thing is when you go to buy a weapon, the specialists are randomized each time you enter the store. With this in mind, you can re-roll the items until you get the exact specialists you want. Which leads perfectly into tip number 2, which is re-roll your items. In Disgaea, you should be re-rolling all the time. This is usually as easy as just backing in and out of a menu. Anytime you go to buy a weapon or receive an item, just try re-rolling it a couple of times to see if you can get better stats or a rare or even legendary version of that item. For me, I was incredibly stubborn and would re-roll until I got exactly what I wanted, but I understand that some people don't have the patience for that. I do think it's worth it to at least re-roll a couple of times just to see what all you can get. Tip number 3 is do not kill any allies. Disgaea 1 has 8 different endings, and if you want the good ending, you want to be sure to not kill any of your allies. This doesn't mean that none of your allies can die in battle, it just can't be you that kills them. So say if you cast an AoE spell and it accidentally kills one of your allies, you want to be sure to go back and reload your save, as not doing so will completely lock you out of the good ending. Tip number 4 is save at the beginning of every new chapter. This one's a small tip, but one you'll thank me for later on. At the beginning of every new chapter, be sure to save your game. Then, go talk to all of the NPCs in the castle, as some of them, over time, randomly give you some really good weapons. And if one does and you don't like the specialist or its rarity, simply reload your save and try again. I got really lucky with the very last weapon you get like this and got a legendary weapon with 2 attack boosting gladiator specialists. So just keep this in mind before you go talking to NPCs at the beginning of a chapter. Tip number 5, check behind the throne. This one is something that is incredibly easy to miss, but you'll want to be sure to do it as you not only get more story context from it, you also get a really, really good item if done correctly. Early on, practically as soon as you can control a Harl, while in the throne room, check behind the throne. You'll find a switch and the game will ask you if you want to press it. And like all hidden buttons in games, you definitely want to press it. After pressing the button in the throne room, head to the main shop area of the game and check the skull on the counter. There you will find another switch. After hitting both switches, head back to the room that connects these two and check out the upper right corner. Etna will say that she needs to use the bathroom and will go into a secret room. Here, Etna will talk about her slowly recovering memories as the story progresses. You will want to be sure to come here at the beginning of every new chapter to not only get a new piece of the story, but to also get a really powerful item close to the end of the game. Tip number 6 is to heal at the hospital whenever possible. Whenever an ally gets hurt or falls in battle, you'll have to heal them up at the Netherworld Hospital. It costs money to do so, but it's well worth it, as over time you receive prizes for healing certain amounts of HP, SP, and fallen allies. You can get some amazing items early on if you're persistent about healing. And of course, these can also be re-rolled. This tip might seem a bit obvious, but once you get it in your mind that you get prizes for healing, you'll start strategically taking damage and letting certain allies fall just to grind towards the next hospital prize. For tip number 7, and to wrap things up, here is a short list of 3 stages that I highly recommend for level grinding. Anyway, that does it for this video. I hope these tips prove useful to you if you are just now getting into Disgaea like I recently did. If you enjoyed the video or found it helpful, be sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you want to see more videos over Disgaea as well as many other JRPGs, be sure to subscribe. As always, thank you so much for watching. I hope you all have a great day, and I will catch you guys in the next video.